Hey everyone, Jitifah Headings here for a video response. Potato Jet came out with a Sirui review, and considering the size of his channel, it got a lot of visibility. Not many hours after it was up, I was already getting questions from people that watched it and were looking for clarification on some of his points. Gene, or Potato, not sure what to call him, clearly did his homework because he talks about using clear image zoom instead of the Super 35 crop. He gives a good example of keeping the horizon level, and the footage he got from the lenses is very good looking. If you're watching this but you haven't watched Potato Jet's video, I highly recommend you do so. Gene, I also hope that you watch this. Thank you for bringing affordable anamorphics into view for so many new people. A few things stood out for me in his video, and they're all sort of off the deep end. So let's begin.
There is one major issue that I have with it, so because of that, I personally probably would never use it on a professional project.
This is a tough thing to say. The ultimate decision comes from budget and the look that you want for the professional project itself. Narrative is way more into the imperfections of anamorphic, while corporate could offer some resistance. There's also a bunch of other professional situations that you can consider, like you can use these for wedding videography that doesn't need a $10,000 lens. So I would definitely take this to a professional project as long as I'm aware of what I'm trying to bring in terms of look. And the look is what dictates this decision ultimately. Shooting anamorphic is accepting compromise. There's no perfect lens. You always have something to deal with. It's too soft, it's too sharp, it's not fast enough. You always have to pick your battles and choose your gear according to the job that you're taking.
But take a look at this close-up of Steve here. It's definitely way overstretched, even though I put in everything correctly. And it becomes very obvious once you put it next to my spherical cine lens, right? So then I was thinking, okay, maybe this actually isn't a 1.33. Maybe it's closer to a 1.3 or maybe 1.25. So I de-squeezed it slightly less. And now everything looks better, even if I put Steve in the edges. Everything looks nice and proportional again. Kind of annoying, but whatever. I just applied that scale to all the clips.
I'm really glad you noticed and pointed this out. A lot of other reviews out there don't catch on the fact that the squeeze factor changes, and that's the biggest compromise on the Sirui lenses. Your example and method to figure out the correct squeeze were quite clever. After noticing the different squeeze, you point out that it's related to the change in focus distance.
Why is this happening? What I then realized is that when you pull your focus to a close-up, it squeezes it less. So when you stretch it back out, it overstretches everything. So basically the amount of squeeze that this lens gives you is very inconsistent, and it depends on where you're focused.
And that's where I would love if you went just a little deeper. The squeeze change is something that comes from the way these anamorphic elements are interacting with each other. The way Sirui lenses focus is called synchrofocus, or mechanical synchro. What's going on is the focus ring you're turning is actually adjusting two sets of glass to produce a focus picture. The front group is the anamorphic glass, and these two elements, as they come closer together, the squeeze factor shrinks. This is not true for all anamorphics. There are many other focusing methods. If you're into it, check my anamorphic cookbook on the channel, as we're getting to focus methods soon with detailed explanations for all of them.
So, but I guess that's why these lenses are $700-800 opposed to $5,000, $10,000, or you know, the high-end ones are 50 grand a pop.
Then you assume that this is a price thing, which is partially correct, but this focus method is used on PS Technics COA Evolutions, which are $20,000 a pop. It was also used on many vintage anamorphics, like the original COAs, Nippon scopes, and the famous Lomo square fronts, like this beast that I have here. The squeeze changes as we focus closer. As you saw from Steve's face, he gets rounder when you get closer and de-squeeze by 1.33. So what Sirui and PS Technic and Lomo, among others, has done is to limit how close you can get. Otherwise, you'll end up losing all the anamorphic squeeze. Anamorphics in general are poor in close focus. And using diopters is a thing that you get used to very early on. Diopters are reading glasses for your lenses.
I've been avoiding handheld because there is no stabilization in this lens. Now, if it's a bigger camera, it's not going to shake as much, so that's not a big deal. Or I could also try turning on IBIS, but still, it's not going to be nearly as stable as a lens with image stabilization built in.
IBIS goes crazy with anamorphics. Using in-camera stabilization, the sensor can move and rotate in 5 different axes. Due to how anamorphics work, if the sensor rolls, that's when you get the crappy results. The only maker that offers a solution for this problem is Panasonic, which features stabilization for anamorphic lenses. The last thing that I have to cover is...
Now, there's also ways to fake the anamorphic look. For example, this is a True Streak blue filter made by Schneider. See, if you take a close look at it, you can see those blue lines going through there, but it disappears as soon as you put it up to the lens. Actually, right now you can kind of see it still, which is not good. Probably because we're all the way at a 16, but once you zoom in, they just kind of disappear. If you take a light and shine it, see that?
A streak filter is a decent solution if you're faking the anamorphic look. As you see, it goes haywire on high key scenes, but works super well for darker environments. The issue that you see when putting the filter over the camera and still being able to see the lines is because you have too wide of a lens. You even guess the issue happens because you're at 16 millimeters. So when you push in, those lines blur out and disappear. Streak filters are a very valid solution, even for high budget projects. Like if you look at John Wick 2, you look closely into the bokeh, you will see the line. You will see the streak because although they were using Arri anamorphics that are super, super high quality, they didn't get the flares that they wanted, so they resorted to a streak filter. And you can tell, the flares look great too. Okay, one more thing. You were also very harsh about anamorphic adapters in this little bit.
And then there was also these adapters that were kind of popular where you can just throw it on in front of any lens and it turns it anamorphic, but I hated those. I remember I was editing a project and someone delivered a bunch of footage where they had the adapter on the whole time and it was on just slightly crooked, so all the footage was skewed when I de-squeezed it, and I remember having such a headache trying to fix it so everything doesn't look all messed up.
I have a tutorial on fixing a little bit of skew in post. I agree, it's a pain to do it over multiple shots, but saying projector lenses or adapters are bad, that's just if you're projecting negative energy, man. There are many of us who use these things on high budget projects and professional sets with amazing results. Ollie Kember is the one that I'm gonna point out today with gorgeous pictures that were already put on London's largest screen. All right. I got everything out of my system. I hope you don't mind me pointing out these corrections, and as you can see, none of them are really super accessible unless you've been into anamorphics for years or following my channel for a while. On that note, if you're not subscribed yet, this is the time to do so. There is a lot of anamorphic talk around here. Actually, that's the whole point of the place. And if you want to jump off the deep end, check out the Anamorphic Cookbook and become a member of the channel. You're going to get a lot of stuff there. Being a member gives you early access to many videos and extra support over the course of building your anamorphic rig. I hope you have a great week and I'll see you next time. Chitfadings out.